light. So the glory will loose that chain and loose that shackle and set them free.
Amen.
You see, obedience always releases something. When you're obedient to God, it always releases something. Sometimes you don't understand it, but just do it. But when you do it, do it with a heart. Don't murmur, because it will stay there. You do it with a heart, say, okay, I'll do it. It makes no sense, but I'm going to do it. Because you know you expect something from God.
Right, that's right.
Always expect God to do it. Always expect God to do the abundance of His glory. His glory pours from the throne room of God. Amen. Just like when you were out in the world, you know, some of y'all didn't go to the party until 2 in the morning because y'all wanted to show your best outfit. I know I was like that.
Me too.
No, it's 12 o'clock. Let it go. Because I want to show what my tailor made for me to walk into that party.
Yeah, yeah.
I make a show. Yeah. Tell the truth. Yeah. Sure, you're laughing because she knows. Keith, you know. You know, minister. So you always expect the party to jump off. And all you're saying is, this party going to be nice tonight. It's going to jump off. You're excited. But as soon as we get in, God, the devil don't want us to get excited because he knows the glory will break shackles and set people free. So we have to have the same desire. So now you're standing there, you're like, okay, God, I'm trusting you. You're stepping in the river, and long as the river hits you here, I don't know what it is about, but long as it hits you on your shoulder, your whole body feels different. It's like a fresh wind. So God wants us, we hit here, we have it here. Because we just have to make one more step before it hits our head. Because you know when pastor be like, go behind, you let it here. You let it, that's like a river of water right up to here. So it's like when he's saying, you let it here, you go behind the fence, you let it here. Because God got something in there for you to change your life. We must live in the world continuously renewing our mind in faith. Faith is born from revelation in our heart. Faith is born from revelation in our heart, because when we have faith, you go in that word, God will reveal His glory and His purpose in our hearts, and it changes you. You see, your mind is something else. By the Holy Spirit, through the word, faith comes alive inside of you. It comes alive. You're like, oh my God, I was blinded to this. Am I really like this? Oh my God, I gotta check myself. And when you come into realization it's you, and not nobody else, you step into the world and it's like, you know something? I come too far to step back now. What are you going to kill me to do it God's way? Let me try going in this water. Because this water got my deliverance. This water got my healing and my breakthrough. And you know, I reached a point that I said to myself, I said, why am I fighting with God? Because I never win. Show me somebody here who always win a battle against God. He makes us look stupid. You know why? We first complain about some things, and in the end, He works it out. Sending your blood pressure high for no reason. Frustrated for no reason. Trying to figure it out for no reason. Sometimes you end up in a hospital. But God, when He comes and He reveals it, you're like, hey, listen, I'm tired of going wrong this over and over. I ain't fighting with you no more, God. I surrender. Do it your way. And that's the easiest way. Because when you do it, God, when you got a joy, no matter what's coming, hurricane could be coming, you're still going to go in. You're still going to do what you got to do for God. And He's going to put everything. We're not in the place we used to be. And I know God is going to take this ministry higher in His glory. Because He's going to have a time. That's why I laugh when He said it. It have a time when God told me going to have a time when people come through the door and no preaching will go forth because of His glory. People will just fall on the floor with their pocketbooks in their hands, because I saw it happen already. Mm-hmm. As soon as they come through the door, they're going to fall out. The glory is going to overtake them, and the glory is going to work through them and in them and break some heavy burdens and change your minds and your hearts, because the glory wants to. Osi, could you read Deuteronomy 28:1-5, and then hit 13. Yeah. Because God wants to show us what His glory brings. His glory brings a lot. I always say I wish I had known all the things I know now when I was younger. I would have lived in church. I gave too much time to the devil in the past. He made my foot hurt so much time. So much time I run from gunshots.
Well,
I'm talking real.
Hello.
So much time that I have to worry about my life.
Sure. But still was going.
And still going, because you know last week the party was shoot out, but you still go because you just want to be there. You see how?
Yeah.
Foot too hot.
Remember Shay?
Yes.
But it's something when God brings you from that place that He reveals who He is.
Yeah. Yeah.
Those things don't bother you no more.
Yeah.
You see the same people partying. The same, but you want them delivered. But for them to get delivered, you gotta make God's glory work in you to deliver them. Because everybody is different and the assignment is different.
Yeah.
So we need God's glory to guide us. His presence to tell us where to go and where not to go. You can't approach everybody the same way like you approach another sister, because it will not work. Because you need God's guidance and glory to show you. His glory is something. But His glory wants to bless us. Read it, O.C.
And it shall come to pass that thou hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and to all His commandments which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all the nations of the earth. And all these blessings shall come on thee and overtake thee, that thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God. Blessed thou shalt be in the city, and blessed thou shalt be in the field. Blessed thou shalt be the fruits of thy body, and the fruits of thy ground, and the fruits of thy cattle, the increase of thy kind, and the flocks of thy sheep. Blessed shall be thy baskets in thy store. Verse 13. And the Lord shall make thee the head and not the tail. And thou shalt be above only, and thou shalt not be beneath. And if thou hearken unto the commandments of the Lord thy God, which I command thee this day, to observe and to do them.
See that? Blessed shall you be in the city. Blessed shall you be. No one's to be blessed like that. You will do one want for nothing.
Well.
That you can have peace and joy all the time. You see, I'm now learning how it is to have peace. I'm not afraid to say it. I'm learning how it is to have peace going through your trials. Real peace. Just everything going on, just saying, God, I trust you. I can't fight against you. And you know what's so funny? The devil wants you to always stay in a place of unbelief. At a place of you doubting yourself and how He's going to move in your life. But we shouldn't try to figure out how God is going to move. Because He's the one with the glory. He's the one with the director. He's the director of our lives. He's the one who dips us in and brings us back out. And dips us in and brings us out. And renew our mind and renew our heart through His glory. He's a God all by Himself, and He don't need no help at all for us. And it says, John 8:32 says, and you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
Amen.
The truth of God will make you free from everything. The truth of God, His glory, will make you free from the things that the enemy tried to bring you to. The truth of God is going to set you free above everything. Hell could be going on, they'll be like, wait, hold up. Why is she so happy, or why is she so calm about this situation? The truth of God, the glory. Because we all get tired sometimes.
Yes.
As soon as I start getting tired, you know what I do? I go back and remember where God brought me from.
Amen.
You know, you have a song that says, I don't believe He brought me this far to leave me.
Mm-hmm.
I think about that song all the time. His glory will transform you. He wants to do something in His people. Your hard faith produced by the revelation of truth is the ultimate key to opening in God's power and His glory. The ultimate key. He's given us the key of victory. The ultimate key to open. And one thing for God's glory to what we have, to add action to our faith. The power of His anointing.
Praise.
We have to add action. He has an intended purpose for us.
That's right. Go ahead.
We can't say, God, do it, and we not doing nothing for God to do it.
Yes.
We can't say, we hear thousands of prophecies. This one come from here, this one come from there. Or God says, don't give me this, and you're not doing nothing. It don't work like that. We have to add action to the intended purpose of God. God wants to do something different in this house. This house is like no other house. This God, the glory, lives in this house.
Amen.
It lives in this house. It abides in this house. It stays in here. So as you walk in, you feel the glory in this place. But God lives in us. And he wants his glory to come out for us to go to the throne room of him so he can come out to manifest, to do the things. So you see, you have to add action. You can't come in the door and say, oh, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. And then say, this man, my bills, you know, I'm studying my bills. And whoever up here is praying up a storm and the glory is in the place, and you're like, my bills, you got to say, devil, get behind me. I am going to study this, but I give this to you, God. I give this to you. I'm going to give you what's due to your name. Take your mind back on how God brought you through. Because if I give each and every one of you all this mind, you all can tell me something that God did for you. So his glory wants to transform us to a place where people out there comes in. We can say, I know how you feel. Let me tell you about my testimony to help deliver them. But we can't do that if the glory is not in us. And if the glory don't walk through us. The glory of God in this house is very important. The glory is the standing thing in this house. God can't do nothing without his glory. We can't sing without his glory. We can't dance without his glory. We can't read a scripture without his glory. We can't function without his glory. We need his glory. I'm going to tell you about a little testimony that happened to me last week. For who don't know. You see, prayer is very important because you never know where, around which corner the devil is. He's always all over. And I believe the devil is all over because that's his thing. He's constantly trying to bring us down. Came from a friend's house and it was late. And I keep on telling my friend, I need to go around the corner on the next side and go to the train station. And she said, no, the train station is right around the corner here. And I'm saying, no, I'm going to go the long way and come around. And she's like, no, it's right around the corner. So I said, okay, it's right around the corner. I had my boys with me. We'll see more about this. I'm telling Jennifer too. And as soon as I came out of the house and I was going around the corner, I heard boop, 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 blah, 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 blah. And I saw a bunch of people running, coming this way. Me and my boys going this way. I heard the Holy Ghost say, turn them around. And I ain't never seen nothing because, you know, you can have kids, and he said, turn around and run, and one of them might go somewhere else that the other one go. They turn around together and start running this way. And I hear God say, let them fall on the floor. I said, get down. They got down, and I got over them. The gunman watched me pass me and gone. My little son was hysterical, but my big son, I was trying to calm the little one down, and the big one said to him, don't worry, Kaylin. That's why God has us praying. It's God's prayers that are protecting us. And I looked at him. He said, God will never make anything happen to us. Even the babies will show you something. Most of the time when a gunman see that you're shooting behind somebody, they will stop and do, but God's glory protected me and my kids. So when I come here, I don't have time to not to say nothing. Because all I have time is to give God the praise, even if it's going well for me, if my house is going crazy, if my kids is acting up, I don't have time to give the enemy no leeway in my life. I gotta give God the praise all the time. And that's just one thing he brought me out of. So I desire God's glory because I want to see my friends.
Yes.
My brother,
amen.
Who's incarcerated, my friends,
yes.
Family members who I know is good people, but goodness don't make you go to heaven. I need God's glory to come in my life, to change their life, because I want to see them happy too.
Yes.
I want to make them know how the goodness of Jesus is never fair, but he's always on time.
Praise
always.
I say, God, you are awesome.
Yes.
I said, you are so awesome. I said, it's just not me alone. I was studying my kids. But at that point, you know what I tell God when I was running? I said, if I get it, I know where I'm going. But protect my kids. But it's amazing how God will use a baby to show you that they're watching everything you do. God's glory is going to do some immaculate things. And I want you to know something, Shay. Your baby coming home.
Amen.
I don't care what it looks like, what's coming down on you. The way you praise God and the glory that's over your life, honey, God will walk right up in you and unlock the key to your victory. What can we tell you that? He's going to unlock the key to your victory because of the glory over your life. A person who prays, a person who gives and cares, God is going to move. I'm not just saying, it's something I know what God said. He's going to move for you. That's the glory. The glory always working out for you.
Amen.
And I just want Zion to know to be blessed.
Amen.
Because we are some blessed people in here.
Amen.
When I see Shirley, I see the glory. I see a powerful intercessor, a powerful evangelist. I see everything in her. I always tell her, ask her. She's a powerhouse.
Amen.
Same thing with Miata when I see her. I don't look at what you all been through. Where the past is, I don't look back at the past because in the past have nothing for us that could grow us, only the future.
Yeah.
So when I see you, I see the same thing, Leanna. And I watch you all, and I say, look at them, they're growing up. And I asked Jennifer, I always say, Jennifer, look at Leanna and Shawnee, oh my God. And Jennifer's like, yeah, they're growing up. You see the thing when you see somebody first from the first foundation, and you see what God does in their life, you'll be so happy. You don't be jealous, you be happy.
Yeah.
Because you know they are young and they're getting it. I wish somebody had told me the same thing they know now when I was young like that.
Amen. Amen.
I watch Danny, how Danny is growing.
Yes, Lord.
This ministry, God's glory is here.
Amen.
I watch how Danny was before when she was timid.
Lord,
remember? And every time somebody go in this church, she go like, what's wrong? Like they got some disease on them. And now you can't say, hold her back. That's God's glory. God's glory is in you too, OC. One thing I love about you, you love the word. That's what draw me to you. You love the word. I could call OC and say, OC, I forgot something in the Bible. Where it says in the Bible, you're like, I'll be like, this man is a walking Bible.
Yes.
One person I'm very proud of is Keith.
Amen.
That's my old street road dog. If you only know how God uses that man.
Amen.
And how the enemy had him, you'll be watching and say, wow. But I see further for him.
Amen.
I see him as a pastor. I see him as pulling out the man from his prison cells. I see him doing a great work in God.
Amen.
How do you see the person next to you? Are you looking through God's glory eye? When I see Shantae, I see somebody who venture like fall, get up, and don't make nothing stop you. Don't make nothing stop you. Because you're in a house that has two pastors, great woman and man of God, who will push you forward and see the best in you. I saw Jazzy coming out her timid moment. Because you remind me so much of Danny.
Yeah.
How Danny used to be. You're a powerhouse. You want to explode. That's what I see when I see you. I see all my sisters and brothers in a different way. And I saw my sister in the back here. I see God do that healing in your life.
Yes, Lord. Yes. Yes.
That's a great thing. Because God going to use you to help somebody else.
Amen.
And I see you coming. When I see people, I don't watch them the same way.
Right.
I always tell Jennifer. I'm always telling her, Jennifer, ask her. Because that's how I ask God for me to see my sisters and brothers. I don't want to see them where they used to be or how they are now. I want to see them afar off. So the glory is going to do what he's going to do in this house.